discuss about the future tense and its various form. That is your simple future tense, future continuous tense, future perfect tense, and the future perfect continuous tense. So all these we will discuss in this chapter. So first you need to understand the definition of the future tense, as what does it mean. The future tense is used to express an action that is likely to take place in future. So all those action which is understood that it will take place after few minutes or after certain period of time, so such kind of action we consider in the future form and we express in a future tense. So there are some example given in your book, that is regarding the simple future tense. It's given there. First example, you can see, to express an action which will take place in future. So people will support the fight against the corruption. So this is the action which can take place, which is going to take place in future. For that we can express in this kind of sentence, so that people will support the fight. So it is understood, if there is, it is going like that, so people will support it. So the fight against the corruption. So it can also be used to express the planned or intended action in future. So something which we plan for the future, so that also we express in a simple future. For example, I will pick up my friend in the afternoon. It is decided, we have planned. So the person can use this expression, I will pick up my friend in the afternoon. So the third is what? To refer to a general statement about the future. So the general statement which is said that it is understood that it will happen. So these are the almost understood statement, general statement. So the Sensex will crumble down as the oil prices are rising. So this is understood, as the oil prices goes up, and so the Sensex, it affects the market, and so the Sensex will crumble, that means come down. So these are the generalization done regarding the future. If it happens, so will the result take place. So we use going to for suggestion in an intention or decision that was made earlier to do something in the near future. So this going to form we are using in this condition, like the teacher is going to distribute chocolate on the occasion of Children's Day. So it is understood that on the Children's Day the teacher will give the chocolate. So it we can express this kind of action in the going to form also, that the teacher is going to distribute. It can also be expressed, Shohan is going to shift to Agra next week. So this going to form also can be used for such kind of a statement. So next is what? We also use going to form to predict the future action when there is a clear indication that it will happen. So something which is understood that it is certain that it is going to happen, then we also use the going to form. Like the baby is going to catch a cold because it's not wearing a cap. So if it is understood in winter, if you don't wear the winter clothes, so obviously the result is what? That we can get sick. So the baby here also is the same example, the baby is going to catch. So going to, we are applying here the word going to catch a cold because it is not wearing a cap. Now will, specifically there are some example given where we can use will in a strong point, like when we decide to do something at a time of speaking, when we are speaking and then we decide, then we use the word will. Like I will have a glass of orange juice. So in that sense, that the person or the one who is speaking is certain that the person is in the need of the juice, so will definitely use the word will. I will have. Then she will lie down for some time as she is tired. So in this kind of a condition also we use what? Will. To express something that will definitely happen, something that cannot be changed, something over which we do not have any control. So there are certain point where we can't do anything and it is going to happen. So this is what we can express here. The scheme will be launched next month. This is understood that it is going to happen. We know about that particular item or a thing, it is going to happen, so we use the word will. The scheme will be launched next month. The buses will not ply tomorrow due to strike. So these are the area where we can use the will with strong point. Now to express the view of the speaker, I will consult a specialist for my eye problem. I will not go for a walk as it is very humid. So the speaker will use the will if the person is speaking about himself and certain that he is going to do that thing. Now to offer to do something, I will make a cup of coffee for the guest. I will pay your telephone bill. So in that condition also we can use, we express in the form of will. The next is your to request somebody to do something. Will you bring my bag please? So when we request in that way also we apply the word will. okay. So to promise to do something, I will bring a goal set for you. So these are the area where we can use the will. Now we will discuss the structure, how to use it for the our sentences. For the simple future tense, the structure will be will, shall, plus root form of the verb. So I shall go to Bombay tomorrow. So here is your subject, shall is your, of course, the part of the future tense. We will use this shall auxiliary verb, then your main verb, and to the rest part of the predicate. So this is what, I shall go to Bombay tomorrow. The second example also we can use with the word will. First one we have used shall, the second is what, will. I will take the exam next year. These are the simple way to express the future tense. So it's a simple future tense where the verb is in a simple form, root form of the verb. Then your second is your future continuous tense, in which we use the structure will be plus ing form of the verb. So we can use in this manner, I shall be, is important here, I shall be, plus what, read ing. So this is what your ing form of the verb, plus ing. I shall be reading a novel, he will be staying here. Next is your future perfect tense. In this, the structure becomes like this, will have plus past participle form of the verb, that is your V3. So then it becomes, he will have finished the work by next year. So will have plus finish, this is your V3, and the rest part of the statement or a sentence. Next is what, she will have returned, again this is your V3, home by next month. So this is what your future perfect tense, because have we are using for the perfect cases. Then the next is your future perfect continuous form of a tense. Will have, here what we use the structure, will have been plus ing form of the verb. So then the statement can become, I shall have been. Here please note it out that earlier we have used be in the continuous form, future continuous. But when we are using perfect continuous, the be changes into been, been. So plus ing form of the verb. So I shall have been writing a novel. They will have been sleeping for 1 hour by 8 o'clock. So these are the structure which I have discussed, so that will be easy for you to understand. Now let us go with the future, with the affirmative, negative and interrogative form. Affirmative is the positive kind of statement, negative is the negative when we use not, and interrogative when we convert into the question sentence. So some example we have just collected for you. For example, the simple future, in that case affirmative sentence will be, she will write. So subject she, and we have used your will, and simple form of the root form of the verb, that is your write. And the negative will become, she will not write. And the same thing we can, if you want to express in the interrogative, that is your question sentence, then it becomes, will she write. Now continuous form, how to make this affirmative, she will be writing, that is ing form, since it's a continuous form. And if we want to express in the negative continuous, then it will become, she will not be writing. If we want interrogative in the continuous form, will she be writing. So this is how we have expressed. Now perfect cases, in that case how it becomes, what are the changes. So affirmative will be, she will have written. See the change here, have is your perfect case, and V3 we always use with the perfect case V3. So that's why have plus written. Negative will be, she will not plus have written. Negative, what we have applied here, not before have. Interrogative, what we are doing, will she have written. So we have applied here will come to the first position, and the subject will come to the second position. So will she, and the perfect is here, since we are using perfect, so it will be have, will she have written. Now perfect continuous, again we will apply what, she will have been writing. It's, we have seen earlier also in the future perfect continuous for the future tense, we are using been. Negative will be, she will not have been writing, and the interrogative will be, will she have been writing. So this is the way we can use into the different forms, into affirmative, negative and interrogative. Now negative sentences also can be expressed in a simple future way. That's some of the statement and the structure I have just written for you. This is what, the subject shall not, plus form of the, your main form of the verb, that is your V form of the verb. So subject, it can be he, she, it, they, whatever. So he shall or he will, whatever it is, according to the statement, he shall not play together. Play here, it is what, your main verb, okay, and this is about the root form of the verb. Now future continuous, subject plus shall not, be plus ing form of the main verb. So then the statement will become, Reena will not be participating. So shall or will, whatever is there, we can use accordingly. So we have used Reena will not plus be and participating. This is your V plus ing in the sports day function. For the future perfect tense, the structure becomes subject plus will not have plus past participle form of the main verb. The boy will not have left. This is your V3 past participle by evening. So these are the negative statement that we have discussed. One more part that I would like to discuss is here your interrogative statements. So how we can express here, for the simple future, the statement is what? Won't or will, subject plus form of the main verb. So then the statement can become, won't you study now? In this way, we can also ask the question sentence because we are discussing interrogative form. Okay, so then we can use here, won't you study now? So this is what you want, will, or whatever it is, and subject will come to the second position. Now for the future continuous tense, we are using what? Will or won't, subject plus be plus ing form of the main verb. So then the statement can become, won't Ritik be attending class tomorrow? So this is how you can make of your own some of the statement to understand. If you understand the structure, you can make varieties of statement. Third is what? Your future perfect tense. Here the structure will become will or won't plus subject plus have plus your past participle, that is your V3 form of the main verb. So then it can become will Vinay have eaten. Eaten is your V3, his breakfast by then. So this is how your interrogative form of the future tense is there. So please go through the chapter. There are various examples given in your book. You can go through it and find out the exercises, solve the exercises in the book. Thank you.